I'm joined now by running backs coach Stephen Downs. Coach, last year the underclassmen pretty much took the reins of the offensive backfield. How much of an importance is that going to be, having that core group of players coming back for this year?
Well, hopefully, you know, it'll be huge. Those kids did a great job. You know, we had a lot of injuries early in the season, and you know, we got a chance to put some of those younger kids in there. And, Lyle Marsh did a great job, and he showed and proved that he can definitely play at the collegiate level and, you know, help us win a championship. So that was awesome to see, and it was great competition throughout the spring. So hopefully we can keep those guys healthy, you know, knock on wood, and we can get after it some.
Now, you mentioned Lyle Marsh, all Ivy last year as well. What kind of role do you see him playing for this year's campaign?
Well, you know, hopefully he can just keep maturing as a player on the field and off the field. He's a very good student of the game, smart kid. You know, he's just a big physical kid. He can put a little bit of punishment on people. You know, he packs a punch running the football, has very soft hands, can do a lot of things, catching the ball out of the backfield. You know, we just got to get his pass pro skills a little bit stronger. But, you know, he's definitely going to help us get better, and hopefully he keeps improving as he, you know, progresses throughout this season here. But, I mean, he'll complement the rest of those kids very well.
Another standout from last year, Michael DiMaggio, a bit hampered with injuries as he battled through all of last year. Can you give us a status as far as him, what he's been doing in the offseason that you know of, and what do you expect from him for this year?
Mike is fine. You know, going into his senior year, I mean, we've had a lot of talks during the spring, you know, throughout spring ball, after spring ball, over the summer, we stay in touch. I mean, he's ready to roll, and he's anxious to end on that right note. So, you know, I mean, he was a kid who, from his freshman year, has really contributed a lot to our offense and our team, you know. And, I mean, I would expect him to come back very strong this fall and be ready for, you know, a championship run and help us do the right things we need to do to be successful.
Hey, you talked about maturity amongst the running backs. Jeff Jack, this sophomore, but not your typical age sophomore. Tell us how much of his maturity, how much does he bring with that to the table for the running backs and a bit of a leadership role?
I think, you know, Jeff being in the situation he is, you know, a kid who's not your typical sophomore, as you mentioned, it helps a lot, you know. And Jeff is more of a straight-laced guy. We've got a lot of characters in our group in the stable, and Jeff is more of the clean-cut guy. So he's our guy that, you know, keeps us in good standing, you know. But Jeff is definitely a kid who, with that maturity, I think it helps him, where, again, he's not your typical sophomore, so he's a lot more mature physically, mentally, and, you know, he's going to be right there and compete with those guys for playing time. And, I mean, we feel that we have three or four kids that could be starting tailbacks or first-team tailbacks for every team in the league. So, you know, we're blessed to have that opportunity to have those kids. And all the coaches kind of tease me and talk about the stable. I need to take them down to Delaware Park and put them on a track, you know. But, you know, those kids, they compete against each other, but they help each other get better. And I think, you know, the kids embrace, you know, Jeff when he came in last year, they embrace Lyle. And those kids just, they see what each other do on the field, and they make each other better that way.
Now, senior fullback Luke DeLuca led Penn all last year in scoring. Do you see him playing more of the predominant leadership role, or do you think it's going to be, in addition to him, a joint effort for leadership in the backfield?
Well, you know, I always tell my guys, be yourself. So, you know, if you're not a vocal guy, or that's not your thing when you're out on the field, don't try to be somebody you're not, because your teammates, they're your buddies, and they can read through the phony attitudes and the phony personalities. So just be yourself. You know, Luke, I think, is more of a leader by example with the way he plays the game, his effort. You know, and he's very physical player. So there's every now and then he'll smack a kid and, you know, de-cleat him, and the kids on the sideline go berserk when they see it. You know, I get excited when I see it. So I always tell those guys, you know, there's nothing wrong with being vocal if you feel the need to, but don't think that you need to go out of your normal, you know, I'd say day-to-day self or scenario to try to be a false leader.
Now, amongst the rest of the backs, do you see anybody else maybe playing a bit of a role of a sleeper, maybe trying to vie for some additional playing time for this year?
You know, it's hard to say. You always want to just kind of see how things play out in preseason. You know, one of the other freshmen from last year, local kid from Jersey, Washington Township, Brandon Colavita, he battled some injuries through the spring, so he didn't really get a chance to step his game up and show what he could do. So I think he's pretty excited. You know, I saw him the other day, and, I mean, he's looking great physically. He's strong. We call him Bam Bam, so you know, obviously he's got a lot of strength with him. But it'll be exciting to see what all those guys do. You know, we have an incoming freshman tailback in Mason Smith, that very talented athlete, athlete from Florida. You know, you never know what'll happen. I mean, last year you saw what happened, and we got a chance to expose, you know, our tailbacks to the world, those freshman kids, and now everybody's like, oh, you guys are loaded, you're loaded, you're loaded. You know, and I mean, injuries help those guys get opportunities to get on the field. You know, Matt Hampshire, he's still going to play a role and do some very good things because he's a ridiculous athlete. You know, so you never know. Hey, we may even put Blackman back there again. So we always got a couple of tricks up our sleeves. So
looks like we have some fun and excitement. Looking forward towards next season, Coach.
Love it.
We thank you very much for your time. And make sure you stay with the PennAthletics.com and the Penn Sports Network for all the latest information on the 2010 football season.